So I'd like to introduce our provost, Jenny Zorn.
Well, I just have to say that when Kurt first was talking to me about the concept of this and what we hoped that it would be and how we could establish it as a tradition, seeing today the number of people that are here, the inductees that that we are respecting today, it really is a very good vision of what we talked about in that very first time that he met with me. So I'm very pleased to see what it is, to hear what the future plans are, to have the photos on the wall, to be able to have access on the web to their histories and such. I think it's really going to be a very one of those traditions that will be very important to the university and for the history and remembering who really built the campus and where we are today. I do want, as we start today, I think most of you know that one of the inductees, Gene Clark, just passed away last week. He did know that he was to receive this award, but I would like for us to just take a moment of silence in Gene's memory today. Thank you. I had a lunch with Gene about a month ago. He was at a group of the political science department that he pulled together because he was shepherding Charles McCall's last wishes and his legacy. And so he met with the political science department and invited me along as well. And it was a typical, I think, setting for Gene and what he tried to achieve. It was very low key. It wasn't about Gene. It was about Charles McCall. There were some alum of Charles's that came and spoke from across the country, that came and spoke to his legacy. And, you know, Gene really was recognizing the fact that we have those faculty members who, some of them that are getting inducted were here from day one, and some of them in those early years. And Gene certainly is one that recognized that and wanted to honor them and their memory. And it was a very nice lunch. He gave me a gift in thanks for some work that I had done with the Sister Cities Project. And that gift hangs on the entrance to my office on the wall there as you walk in. And it means very much to me. Gene was a generous person, and you'll hear more about him later. He was a generous person of mind to the students that spoke about him and how he mentored them. Was very impressive. He's also very generous of heart. And I know most of you in this room knew Gene. So it's a gift that I see in my office, and I will remember him always. Well, I didn't know all of the nominees. I was fortunate to be able to know Gene. But they are legends. When I see their pictures flashing across here and hearing the stories that I've heard over the past few years since I've been here, they are amazing people. They are amazing people who have built this campus. And it makes us all proud to be able to say that we work here at CSUB. These are the folks that made this such a fabulous institution and a wonderful place to work and a wonderful place to have colleagues. So because of their work, we're honoring them today. And we really look forward to the other people that we can nominate and honor into the future. As Kurt said, the committee have many nominations. It was very difficult for them to select who should be inducted in this first class. So I do remind you nominate people. If they were nominated this year, nominate them again. We have a number of outstanding people back historically from the campus that we need to make sure that we recognize, as well as those that are more recently retired from our ranks. So today, let's honor those people, let's thank them for their contributions and what they have done for this campus, and so that it makes us proud to be CSUB. Thank you.
Was the nominator, and we'll be presenting the information about him.
Thank you. Provost Zorna was doing good until the conversation. Thank you for the introduction. So you guys know, we knew that Gene was in ill health, and we worked out that we would come up first because if we got up here, we were only going to have him here for about 15 minutes or 20 minutes, as you know. He didn't make it. So what I want to do is introduce Gene's family. Camille Clark, you want to stand up, please? Alondra Perry. Her husband, Kevin Perry. And their daughters, Nicole and Melissa Perry. I thank you for being here, and I thank you for being here. I want to start off by saying that Gene represented everything that I've ever thought about when I think about a gentleman scholar. And when he talked about his stories of Europe, even Germany, it was really interesting because I came here as a scholar in comparative politics. And Gene at the time was teaching American politics, he was teaching judicial politics, he was teaching pre-law, he was doing all these things. And I surprised myself, and I think Gene surprised me, because I didn't learn that Gene was a comparativist, that he did comparative politics and international relations when he first got here in 1972. And that's just the way Gene was, because over the years, Gene would simply take on all the classes that others didn't want to teach. And he evolved. And he evolved as a person, he evolved as a scholar. And one of the things that I learned was that when you're in a profession that serves, that means you just don't serve your clientele, you serve your colleagues. You work with your colleagues. You try to make the life you have around you not only as professional as you can make it, but as make it as comfortable as you can for those who are in your professional environment. And you know, one of the things, talking with Tina over the last couple of days, Tina Giblin, Tina's back, where are you at, Tina? Are you still here? Okay, raise your hand. One of the things talking with Tina is that Tina Giblin, who was office manager for our office 20-something years, I think, Tina made it clear that that Gene was the type of person who always listened. And not just listened, but he listened with his heart. And so rather than going through his long list of accomplishments, and you'll see these in the press releases, I mean, there are just too many things to list. I'm gonna talk about one of the stories that stands out for me about Gene listening with his heart. I think I was in my second and third year, and Gene, I brought a student to Gene, and I said, look, I caught her cheating. My second or third year, I didn't know what to do with the student. I had my ideas. And Gene said, well, what do you want to do? I told him. He said, okay. Well, the next thing I know, I see the student in Gene's office throughout the rest of that quarter, the next year, And one of the things I learned was that Gene asked the student what was going on in their life. And he listened. And this is why I say Gene listened with his heart. Because that student graduated, and I don't know what happened to that student. I know that she didn't take another class with me. I think Gene got my message. But what I learned from that was that, you know, you can treat people with decency, even when they've messed up. You should treat people with respect, because they're going through things in life that maybe we don't know about. And what I learned from that that episode with Gene is that we should take our profession seriously, but we should take each other more seriously, and we should look into what's going on in our lives and the lives of others. And again, as far as I know, I think that student graduated, but I can imagine that Gene forever transformed her life. And so I want to end with and I know we only have a couple minutes, but I just want to say that at the end of the day, Gene represents, in my view, the best of our profession, and I think he represents the best of ourselves. And I think as far as the first group of people coming into this CSUB Hall of Fame, I'm just proud that Gene's among this first group, because looking at the group, and I see the one guy here, Gus Garcia, this is a phenomenal group, and I'm just proud to be part of this process. Thank you.